Little bit of a different one today. Welcome to the podcast, Sunday evening podcast. I like this, Thursdays and Sundays. And I'm going to do something today that I really show or play on a podcast. It's something I've been thinking about a little bit more recently. Just looking for some voicings. Just kind of the other side of my process. Like, I don't just sit here with the bass all the time. Hey, the room sounds and feels a little bit bigger when I'm sitting at the piano. That's using the term piano pretty fucking loosely. I have one of these Native Instruments. Very nice, actually. I really dig it, but it's not a real piano. It's the Native Instruments Complete Control, of which I don't have complete control of it, but that's what it's called, the S88. And I'm using Keyscape, which has a rather nice grand piano. Spectrasonics Keyscape. And I spend a lot of time at the piano. I spend a lot of time at the piano working on harmony and all kinds of stuff. Writing especially. Just that, like that simple reharmonization, for instance. Same melody, same ostinato in the right hand. It's the C, G, F, and then moving the bass line around underneath it to reharmonize. Having the melody in the middle, you just get to so many other things when you're not sitting with the instrument that you know so well and you can do so much with. And when my technique is severely limited, this is a great, it's a great teacher. It's a great way of, being like, oh yeah, okay, dial it back. Music comes first, melody comes first, harmony comes first, rhythm comes first. The instrument does not come first. The instrument is just a consequence, just an afterthought almost. Yeah, I like that. Yeah. See, I don't have the touch so much to make certain parts sing out as much as I would like. When I hear someone like Keith Jarrett or Brad Meldow, or you know, pick an amazing classical pianist that is dealing with multiple areas of the range for melody at the same time, and being able to transfer that from up here in the to then making an ostinato in the right hand. we get into move around. Keep doing this at the end of the podcast before we really get going in this podcast. Not sponsored by anyone but myself, I guess. Invested my own time into the podcast to do this. And as a result, I will tell you very quickly about JanekGwizdala.com, where all of the books, talking actually about a lot of this stuff that I sit down at the piano and work on, it's actually transferable completely to bass. Maybe I'll even pick up my bass before the end of this episode. All the books are at JanekGwizdala.com in the store. If you want physical copies of those books, they are at Amazon.com. They ship worldwide rather rapidly. I'm always pretty amazed by that. And they all come with videos and play-alongs and all kinds of extra stuff, all included in the book. Those are not an add-on. And yeah, I go into great depth about this and sort of dedicated subjects and courses at JanekBassStudio.com. So those are my two plugs, and we'll get on with the episode. I'm kind of digging this ostinato. See that? I'd like that melody to stick out. This thing, that's almost... so many places we could go with this. Obviously, you don't have to move the melody. That's kind of... Okay, before I get ahead of myself, that's kind of where I operate. The melody is kind of dictating... Well, a melody is the melody. And then I just have so many options of places I can go under that. So right now, the ostinato is staying static. But still the top note of the voicing, I'm conscious of, and what goes underneath there. All kinds of options here. Minor 7 flat 5. Minor major. So many options. But once I get away, just before I started talking about the books and doing my little ad plug, I did start moving up. Maybe that should be a sus, actually, I think. By the way, this is not written down. Obviously, audio podcast, no video. You can't see what's going on here, but nothing's written down. It's just where my ear is taking me. Really important to be conscious of that, I think. I've been working on some of these Barry Harris things. Sixth diminish concept, adding an extra note to a major scale, so basically putting a note between the fifth and the sixth. So you play major scale and just put that, we're in the key of C, put that A flat in between the G and the A, and you get all these beautiful chords that borrow from diminished. There's so many things going on in there, so that helps inform some of my reharms and melodic options and inner moving part options as well. You can can do that with minor as well. There. It's like being melodic and harmonic minor in the same scale. Or, but you have both. Ah. Intense. Love that. Ooh, so nice. Sound familiar? This is how it happens. Shit, I get off on a tangent sometimes. That's not a bad idea, actually. Play the third as the melody. Then play sixth. I want to play this. Maybe like that. Fingers. I haven't done, haven't been doing these exercises enough. Not quick enough. So I start to kind of get a form together now. Maybe this is the opening statement. Just to release some. Now I'm thinking about the orchestration of it, because I sat down and wrote the union kind of like this. And I didn't think enough about orchestration on that record, I don't think. I think Patitucci did an amazing job producing it. The guys did an amazing job playing the music, and Patitucci was really awesome in the studio producing it and at his house rehearsing and stuff and bouncing ideas and just being an amazing set of ears. But I don't think I did enough prep time up front to really orchestrate it the right way. And when I listen to a Shy Maestro or Brad Meldow, some classic piano people, classic piano players who do really great jobs of orchestrating with just the trio, and how much is possible there, I think. Next time out, if I write anything vaguely melodic like this for a new record or have a new project like this, I've really got to think about the orchestration and the vehicle in which I play it and record it. That's a shit voice to go next. I do want to. We could go. Why am I doubling those? Interesting. Maybe. I don't want to give away that minor major. I want to go to the minor seven there, I think. Just put a better voice in. Because I want the minor major there. Maybe I just write this for someone else and have them play it. Different artists. I'm going to go minor there. But 11, I think. Sounds bad. I'm kind of searching there. I do want to go up a half step with the melody, though. That's where I'm hearing it go instead of... right now I have it... I love major chords with the three and the four in them. What can I get from F minor major 9 to E flat major with the four in it? Or is there just a better option here? We're so far away from this major now. Kind of got to bring it back somehow. Or not, I guess. Sus and then 13 flat 9 or minor. Maybe just that. So 4-5-1. So those are just triads, in case you're wondering, just A flat and E. A flat and E over C. The two triads share one common tone, the G flat, which I really, which is not uncommon to see here. I'm a big fan of this kind of sound. So Yeah, and so it goes. Next step, probably to record some of this stuff and, start fleshing out ideas. Thankfully, just checking how long we've been rolling. 27 minutes. Awesome. Sorry about the noise. Yeah, next thing is probably to write a few of these ideas down. Thankfully, I'm recording the podcast, so normally I'd just be recording. Oh, yeah. Stay hydrated, folks. But it's actually not bad. It had no intention of that happening, which is great, because that's when the stuff should come out. The better stuff, shall we say, should come out. Work on the Barry Harris shit in 12 keys a little more, so I'm not kind of fumbling around when I get to certain chord voicings. Repetition as well, that's the other thing. Like, if I'm okay playing it, I mean, you might be sick of hearing that thing already, but if I'm okay, and I am right now, if I'm okay playing something over and over and over again like this, it's normally a good sign, and it's good to just get it in the brain and just, I don't know, what has my process been before? Yeah, just repetition. The more it sits there, the more it feels like a form. And then the more I play it, the more, obviously the more I can improve it, but the more I can feel out the bigger picture of the form as well. And right now I'm sitting at the piano, like I said, something I'm not terribly good at, especially when you compare it to the bass or something. So it's a good discipline, I think, to do that. And then things will open up, you know, once I put it into the computer and start building a song form and playing some bass and finding some other melodies. And like I said, orchestration. Arrangement, that's going to be key, I think, with something like this. If I ever put something out like this again, in terms of sort of melodic acoustic music with an electric bass, I don't know what the fuck that is. To E minor voicing. What is that? Maybe it should be the minor major there. Oh, I like that. Maybe I go up there. I feel like I need a change there. Ah, that was nice, but not that third one. Thank you. the transition. Get it right. Getting somewhere now. No. Now you see how there's a long, little bit of a longer form developing, and I'm kind of adding to it at the end. Got to solidify this idea. Okay, so I'm here. That's what I'm looking for. So, we should double it up there, I see. Thank you. So you see, I've had about three different endings to the section so far. Hear that? Some random like guitar doubling that melody. I want to go sus, maybe. Then I don't get the big A to A flat, do I? Possibilities, and I'm glad I'm hearing them. That's one positive here. There are probably too many, and I'm gonna chop a bunch of this out. That will be the process. But I'm glad I'm hearing them rather than just forcing things in there. Like they're actually falling under my fingers as and when my ear says go there, which is great. That's a big step forward. That's always the goal, is to have the ear dictate the music rather than the technique and the facility on the instrument. Luckily, I have, like I said, very little, but I'm loving this. Too long. like the way that bit starts. Beautiful movement. That's a nice motivic development, actually. So you get G over B to F over A to A flat minor 13. I like that. Nah, I can't go minor there. And I gotta say, I haven't stopped to think about what these chords are, for instance. Just going by feel and by ear at the moment. And maybe I just go down and forget the minor. Yes! Yes! That's it. Starts to feel good now. Blow over the changes now. But that was my rough attempt at that. Okay, one more time with the yeah, I gotta be a little more play those melodies with a little more purpose. Be delicate with these things. It's so fucking important, the melody. I'll drive myself nuts about it. I'll be in here for days or for weeks just figuring out that just the right touch for the melody. And that change of register as well. So we're kind of digging in, pretty hard. This one. Yeah. Shit, now I've got another option there. Flat better. That little comp thing in the left hand. What's that? That little. All right. I'm going to do this for hours. I can't record this and possibly put that out there and hope to keep an audience for hours and hours and hours. So yeah, I'll call it a day for the day. Thanks for hanging out on a slightly different, at least a slightly differently orchestrated podcast, a little piano action today. Yeah, JanekGwizdala.com, JanekBassStudio.com. And with all things being equal, I'll see you on the Thursday podcast. All right, Cass, take it easy.